Hello everyone, Sons and Duck 2, welcome to part 3 of my WTBW machines overviews. In this part we'll be covering the generators, a bunch of other typical machines for processing things, and finally the upgrades you can put in the machines, and other components. So, yeah. Just move them. And we'll set the time to day. You've got set machines such as your powered furnace made with crowdium and a machine block, like so, a copper coil. You've got the crusher made like so with a piston, iron block, and a few other resources to swap out the furnaces for those. The compressor being pistons on the side and then crowdium where the others were. The fluid generator being with just iron and a redstone block. You've got your solar panels with the prior tiers and a few other ingredients, such as wafers, which you'll need in the to make in the compressor, of course, depending on what you've got access to. There's obviously a bunch of other details, like dark crystals for other things, but we'll get to those, of course. But, yeah. While demonstrating what these can do, including the charger, which I've also forgotten about, we'll test out the power pipes along with the generators. So, simply, we'll just put some connections here, and we've got the 512, 1K, and 4.1K options for, I think this is forge energy, if I remember correctly. And you've got plates and then prior tiers for recipes there. But we'll see what these are capable of. Now, there's no indication here with JEI support, so we'll just put, say, some ores in and see what happens, at least not with, like, clicking on the icon. Now we'll get our generator, fuel one specifically. Actually, we do have a connection we can make there, and our battery, like so. So we'll get coal, and obviously this will produce 45 of EF per tick. Store up to 150,000 there, 2,000 here, and we can see this now processing, using up a fair amount. That'll turn into dust, smelt into ingots, and you get the idea. Obviously you can compress it into plates via ingots, or if you want to smelt in the furnace, obviously all furnace recipes will most likely work. If we actually go to the crusher though, let's see if we can find, yes we can. So we've got ore related recipes for even emerald, you've got wool recipes to give you string, you can break down nether bricks as well, you can break down smooth quartz and a few other things, ingots, bones to get bone meal, diamond dust, flowers to get dyes, obsidian to make obsidian dust. You've got a cobble to gravel to sand recipe as well. Keep going along, we've got others like an enderpearl and a few other ones to break down. So, ore summit that obviously does have a recipe. It's not going to pull from others though. Yep, so it has its own recipes for even other ore summit, not pulling from other mods that you have, for example, which I don't have currently here, but of course. So there's that, and you can see the rate that it's obviously doing things is quite normal, but if we wanted to use upgrades, for example, which I'll just wanna trigger here, you can see there's obviously many types for speed, power, and otherwise, which we'll just cover real quick, because obviously they'll operate accordingly in the other machines. So you've got a power one with a upgrade base, which you need to make in a compressor with groundium. So we just put, say, number one here. Energy is going up quite. Energy is used up quite quick, so we'll just increase that for us, so we don't have that as a problem. We can see how much faster that is. We've got upgrade two, which you can put in. I don't think you have to stack these, however. You should obviously tell the difference of. There, do speed upgrade 3, we can see how quick that is. And then we'll pull the prior tiers out, and it's still fairly fast, surprisingly. Now you can't use multiple of the same, I think. Or you can, possibly. Nope, seems to be you can. Obviously it's reduced a lot of our power, but yeah, so you can stack these here, but you can't, like, put 64 and expect it to work. So there's that. But that's how fast the crusher will operate, of course. You've got energy upgrades, which increases this to 100,000 versus otherwise. No, that's power usage, so that's efficiency, I should say. So for example, if we had our speed upgrades here, we'd provide some efficiency to it. So it's kind of still trying to pull from somewhere. And it's kind of trying to be efficient as best as it can, by the looks of things. If we put in 2, we'll see how much it can handle now. And if we do 3, you can see how much more efficient that is, at least with multiple there, of course. If we just did the 1, that's how much of a difference that makes. So you've got power efficiency upgrades as well as speed. You've got capacity where it increases it like so to 500,000, which is now at 2.15 giga FE. That doesn't seem to be the difference there. Okay, so we just sort of... Okay, that's kind of strange. Okay then, not too sure there. I don't think you can use these on the battery either. No, you can't. Okay. And then batteries for obviously storing and ejecting power. So just which you need the charger for, which we do have access to. And my guess is that you possibly just put it on the side? No? Okay. Can't shift click it in. Maybe use furnace fuel? Nope, okay. Not too sure on that then. I don't know if there's like a specific mode to do this. Not too sure. There's no discharger, so I don't know really how you use the battery for that, but either way. Moving on though, furnace, we'll see how capable that is on its own. Obviously with upgrades, it'll be as fast as the crusher. So that's how quick that performs. It doesn't seem to... Okay, that might be the output slot, that's why. Yep, so that's that. We'll try obviously with a hopper. And we'll see that it can output that way. And then more sand's gonna fall down. Alrighty, so... So that's outputting the dust. That's doing that. And my guess is that you could obviously use a crusher to a hopper, to a furnace, to then send the dust over if you wanted. But, don't need to do that. We've got the compressor. If we check for recipes, we can see that it just makes plates as well as wafers for many of the other components you'll need to make. And we'll see how fast that is. So, I'm just gonna get a gold ingot, for example. We can see how fast it processes normally. And there we go. And it'll just output to the hopper now that we've got that below. We've got the hydrator, which needs water. Which if we... So we can try right-clicking, and if for some reason it doesn't pick up on it. So if we put a bucket in here, nothing there either. So you probably do need water pipes to connect to here. But we'll just check, say, recipes, just in case if I can't get this working. And you can see that it's for dyes, as well as mossy cobble, magma blocks to obsidian, chiseled to mossy, and then you've got slime balls from potatoes, which is quite interesting. We've got the dehydrator being a reverse of it, but for coral, it seems, as well as turning food that's cooked into leather. Saplings to dead bushes, kelp to dried kelp, so, yeah, and there's that, so that's the difference there. Most likely you'll want fluid pipes in here, but as far as I can tell, I can't work out a way to get that out to have water. But you also do need water for the dehydrator, apparently, so that's interesting. So we need to get, say, some coral, and that's just power on its own, right? Possibly not then, okay. This is what I needed. Yeah, and that's just going to perform its tasks. So you're going to need fluid pipes for the other, there's no way about it. For some reason I can't bucket it in here, which is really odd that I can't do that. And then finally we have the charger, obviously, for charging things. Such as, say, batteries, or... I don't think there's power tools? I'm trying to remember. Magnet, levers, no power tools, but if you did probably have any that happened to use, of course, forge energy. You've got that as an option. But otherwise, that's probably it.